Hello everyone, I'm Josh and welcome back to another 3D Revolution. Now, the CR10 3D printer you see behind me is arguably the best go-to budget 3D printer available right now. It's got a massive build volume, it's less than £400, it's good quality and it's reliable. There's one drawback though, it sounds like a rocket taking off. So in this video, I'm going to be looking at things you can do to make this thing a hell of a lot quieter. So like I've said, the CR10 is a fantastic printer, but it is so loud. I've got a few projects coming up which is going to keep this thing printing around the clock. So I need to find a way of making this a lot quieter so it doesn't keep me and my housemates awake whilst it's printing at night time. But what actually makes it loud? Well, this can be divided into two different sections. You've got the control box and you've got the printer itself. Now the control box has three fans inside and they are loud and they are cheap. And that is what contributes to most of the noise on this printer. So inside there, you've got three. You've got one at the back, which is for the ventilation. You've got one in the middle, which circulates air, and you've got one in the PSU. In this video, I'm going to be replacing both the ventilation one at the back and the circulation one with much quieter fans, which have at least the same amount of output. I'm going to leave the PSU on for now and see how much of a difference the other two make. On the printer, there are a few different things that we can change. Now, the main thing that makes the noise from the printer is going to be the motors, and it's going to be them causing vibrations that travel into the frame, and that alone will make a lot of noise, and that can then travel down through the frame into your table or your stand, whatever you've got it sat on, and that's going to emanate around the room. So the first thing that I'm going to be changing on the printer itself is adding these. Now, these are vibration dampener mounts, specifically designed for the NEMA 17 motors on this printer. And all these are a couple of sheets of metal and a bit of rubber in the middle, which should isolate the vibrations. And you can get these from Banggood, but I will pop a link in the description below to anything that I'm adding to this printer so you can find it easily. The next thing that I'm going to be adding is one of these. And this is just a 1mm thick washer, which I've printed, but you can use any washer. And that's going to be going onto the right-hand side of the X-axis belt. Now, this may not be on everyone's, but I've heard online that quite a few people have this issue, and I've got it on mine, where on the right-hand side of the belt, it's actually off-axis, and this means that on any X-axis move, that belt is rubbing against the frame. Now, I've not noticed any impact on the quality of my prints with this, but when it does a fast X-axis move, it can be quite loud. So popping this on there is going to shift that belt a bit over to the side, and it should run much more smoothly. And whilst I'm doing that, the last thing I'm going to be doing is removing these blue rubber strips that are in the frame. Yours might be orange or a different colour, depends on where you bought your printer from. But what I've read online and quite a few people have complained about is that things on your printer, part of the X-axis bar and the wheels, can rub against these at certain points in a print. And it can cause issues with your print itself, but if it's rubbing, then it's probably also making some sort of noise. It's probably not significant, but I'm going to remove them whilst I'm at the rest of this anyway. So, before we get going, let's take a listen and see how noisy this printer actually is right now. Okay, so you can hear we've already got quite a lot of noise there, and that's just from the control box. So, let's have a look at how much that actually is. We're getting about 55 decibels there. So let's take this up to the next stage and start moving the X-axis a bit and see how much we get then. So with the X-axis moving, we peaked at about 60 decibels. So let's get these changes made and see what we have at the end of this video. Before starting any work on the control box, remove the power cable, switch it on, and then back off again. This will help remove any excess power left over in the components inside. Remove both cables from the back of the box, and any memory card you may have plugged in the side. Finally, remove the filament holder by removing the two screws on the top.
For the work I'm doing inside the control box, I'm using a Gellert Silent 5 fan for the circulation, and I'm using a Noctura fan for the vent at the back of the housing, which appears to be making most of the noise. You'll also need the tool set which came with your CR10. Flip the control panel upside down, and using an Allen key, remove all 5 screws from the bottom of the housing. When you remove the bottom panel, the first thing you'll see is the power supply unit. Now this has its own fan, but we're going to leave that one for now and concentrate on the one on the back and the middle. To remove this, we need to switch this into its side and remove the last 4 screws from the side of the external housing. Once you've done that, place a box to the side of the housing to rest the power supply unit on, as we're not going to be removing any of these cables and you want to be really careful with them. Okay, so this is the circulation fan, and at the back there is the exit fan. This one circulates the air over the components and then pushes it out the back. Let's remove this circulation fan using the 2 screws at the bottom of the case. You'll then find 4 further screws attaching it to a metal frame. You'll need to remove these, but I found mine to be extremely tight. I started out just using a screwdriver, but eventually I had to use a Leatherman to loosen them up before I could actually get them out of there. Cut both of the wires, leaving a long enough cable inside the printer to attach the next fan with. Strip the ends of the leftover cables and prepare them for soldering. Now let's take a look at the fans themselves. This is the one that I've removed, and this is the new one that I've got, the Gellert Silent 5. Both fans are the same size in profile, so they can use the same screw fittings. However, the new one is a bit thicker. This shouldn't be an issue, but it does mean you might need longer screws. Trim the wires, but make sure you know which one does which. If you've got 3 cables on your new fan, you should only need 2 of them, a power and a ground. Once you figure that out, get them soldered up, but make sure to put some sort of insulation on the cable first. Then you can get your fan refitted. Now let's move on to the rear extractor fan. This one is again held in place by 4 screws, each of which can be removed by an Allen key. Once you've got them removed, pull it away from the case, but you'll find that it's still being held in place by a cable tie at the bottom. You'll need to snip this to have more room, but be very careful not to cut any of the other wires. Once you've removed that, you should be able to move the fan a lot further away, and you'll have more room to play with whilst snipping its own wires. Again, make sure that you've left a lot of the cable inside the case ready to connect your new fan to. As before, get your new fan soldered on and make sure that you insulate both wires to avoid any shortages inside the case. Once that's done, you can get the fan screwed back in place. You'll then need to attach another cable tie to tidy up the cables inside and allow good air circulation. And that's it for the control box. It's just a matter of popping it all back together now. So getting the power supply unit screwed back in place, being careful not to strip those threads, tuck down the cables at the back to make sure they're not trapped when you put the bottom panel on, and then just pop the final 5 screws back in. Now the control box is completed, we can move on to the next step. For the motor vibration dampeners, I'm starting with the X-axis motor. To begin with, just use an Allen key to remove the 4 screws connecting the panel that holds the end stop. Make sure to take hold of it before you remove the last screw so it doesn't fall. Next, use a spanner to lightly loosen each of the spacer screws. The rest of this can be done by hand, but they can be a bit tight to begin with. Again, make sure when you get down to the last screw to hold onto the motor so it doesn't drop. And then carefully remove the motor, making sure not to pull on the belt. While slotting the dampener onto the motor, you'll notice that it neatly fits into the circular recess on the front. You'll also notice that you only need to screw in 2 holes. However, because the spacer screws won't stretch this far, you're going to need 2 additional screws for this. Next, loosen up the 2 slugs on the gear so we can move it further along the drive column. Place the motor roughly in place with the belt around the gear and figure out how far out this gear needs to be placed. Once the belt looks like it's running straight, you can then tighten up both the slugs again using your Allen key. From this point, you can then screw in 2 of the spacers, tightened with a spanner, and finally the end stop. And you can repeat this exact same process with the Y motor at the back of the printer. Removing the colour strips is really easy and only needs to be done on the two vertical bars and the two horizontal bars attached to them. Start out by loosening the two screws attached to the right-hand side of the X-axis. This allows you to remove the bearing at the end of the X-axis belt. It also allows you to access the end of the rubber tube, which you can then pull out either with your fingers or a pair of pliers. Then simply put the bearing back into place and tighten it, ensuring that you've pulled it out enough so the belt also remains tight. Finally, we just have the top bar and the side bars. For the top bar, you can just remove the plastic cap at the end. Put this aside, and then you can pull out the rubber strip. That cap can then either go back on, or you can leave it off. It's only for aesthetics. Next, unscrew the two screws at the top of this bar. This will allow you to slide it back, and slide out the two strips on the vertical bar. This will need to be repeated for the vertical bar on the opposite side, but take extra care not to bend or damage your Z-axis's threaded bar, and then you can simply put everything back together.
Okay, so that's all the changes done. I've replaced two of the fans in the control box, the middle circulating fan with a Gelid Solutions Silent 5. I've replaced the ventilation fan at the back of the unit, which seemed to be making most of the noise, with a Noctura. Noctura are pretty much the best brand of fan you can get if silence is your high priority. So I'm going to put a link to all of these in the description below. In addition to that, I've added the vibration dampeners to both the X and the Y motors. I've also removed the blue rubber strips. The only thing that hasn't necessarily gone according to plan was my small orange washer, which I'd printed out for the X-axis to slide the belt across. It seems the design wasn't quite as I thought it had been before I took it apart, and basically it doesn't make any difference. So I am going to be designing and producing a solution for this, and once I've done that I'll create a new video, but for now that's going to have to stay as is. So let's see how the changes that I've managed to do have impacted on the volume of this printer.
Well, I can already tell that is a hell of a lot quieter than it was before. There's pretty much no sound coming from that control box. And in fact, the only sound I can hear is coming from this fan here, which is to cool the heatsink above your heater block. That might be something that I look at changing in a future date, but for now, let's see how quiet this thing has actually become. So we're averaging about 40 decibels there, which is considerably quieter than it was before when there was no movement. We were getting about 55 decibels when there was no movement before. Let's try adding in some X-axis movement. So it seems the X-axis doesn't seem to impact the sound levels at all now, so I'd say that's a success. We've lost 15 to 20 decibels from our sound range there, and I have a feeling this app on the phone actually is being oversensitive, as this is extremely quiet. To me, this is a whisper at best, and there's no way that this is going to be heard outside this room, so I say this entire process has been a major success.
Well, I hope this video has helped you make your CR10 a hell of a lot quieter than it was before. It's definitely improved for me, and I'm looking forward to getting some printing done in peace. If you have any questions or if you'd like to see something else done, let me know in the comments below and make sure to subscribe. See you next time.
Thanks for watching, and remember, hit subscribe for more news, tips, and live streams on everything 3D and tech.